Forward! Forward!
This is Lorne Greene. Each year, in the nation's capital, thousands of visitors, army families, and guests travel to the vast, echoing gymnasium of historic Fort Myer, Virginia, to witness one of the nation's most impressive and well-known pageants, Prelude to Taps. Sponsored by the Military District of Washington, and with the musical support of the United States Army Band and Chorus, the pageant is performed by the officers and men of the elite 3rd Infantry, the Old Guard, whose battle honors date back to the beginnings of the nation. By tradition, only the Old Guard fixes bayonets without voice commands to the beat of drums.
Sound fixed bayonets!
With a salute to you, our audience, the Prelude to Taps begins. Record of service and sacrifice dating back to 1775, the United States Army has made its contribution to the survival and growth of our nation. Recalling that heritage of service, the Army flag with its 55 battle streamers. From the flag fashioned by Betsy Ross to the 50-starred banner of today, history has recorded the unique effectiveness of the citizen soldier. I am an American fighting man. I do not stand alone. By my side and in support of me are many others as brave and competent as I. They help me in my country's stand for freedom for all men. I do not stand alone. Shortly before dawn, on an April day in 1775, the word came, to arms, the British are coming. At that call, citizens became soldiers, and the American Army was born. Captain John Parker said to his men, stand your ground, don't fire unless fired upon, but if they want war, let it begin here. The call to arms was heard throughout the 13 colonies, and the drumbeat of colonial musicians led the Minutemen to Lexington and Concord and beyond. fife and drum corps of the old guard wears the red-coated uniform which made musicians of General Washington's army easily recognizable through the smoke of battle. And the tunes it plays are authentic. Although widely used in Europe, the bugle came to the American army only in the late 1700s. Despite its limited range of notes, a skilled soldier can make it sing. Concluding its performance, the Old Guard Fife and Drum Corps renders honors to you in the tradition of the Continental Army by passing in review at the slow and stately troop step. Sights and sounds which call to mind the hard and costly steps on America's road to freedom. The bitter cold of Christmas night 1776, when General George Washington crossed the Delaware to lead the newly formed colonial army to victory over the British. The War of 1812, where British forces, fresh from victory over Napoleon, met defeat against the riflemen of Andrew Jackson at the Battle of New Orleans. In the final battle of the Mexican War, the 3rd Infantry gained its nickname. General Winfield Scott said to the officers of his staff, "Gentlemen, take off your hats to the old guard of the army." By the mid-19th century, the seeds of division had taken root in the land, and the Civil War, the tragic war of brother against brother, brought once again the partings that soldiers and those they love have had to endure since soldiering began. During 4 years of bitter struggle, the Union survival was tested. The eyes of the tall president of Illinois grew shadowed with strain. But in the end, the Union was preserved. Having survived this crucial test, the nation expanded westward, not without determined opposition, but inevitably nonetheless. With the action at Wounded Knee Creek, the Indian campaigns ended, and the nation stretched secure from ocean to ocean. Now, for the first time, American soldiers were called into conflict beyond our shores. The Spanish-American War brought Cuba's liberation from Spanish domination and earned Teddy Roosevelt and his Rough Riders an enduring place in American history. The second decade of the 20th century brought to the American soldier his first experience of combat in Europe, and to the world, its first global conflict. For the doughboy, it was a new challenge, but his leadership was equal to the task. General John J. Pershing was to guide them to victory over there. On his return from Europe, General Pershing, as Chief of Staff, ordered the creation of the United States Army Band. This was done, and today it bears his name. Now the United States Army Band and Chorus give you a demonstration of the versatility of your Army's foremost musical organization as they present A Showcase in Sound. Thank you. Two decades after World War I, World War II was upon us. Under General Douglas MacArthur in the Pacific and General Dwight Eisenhower in Europe, another threat to the independence we declared in 1776 was defeated. Then, after only 5 years, a new and undeclared conflict brought American soldiers face to face with a new enemy halfway around the world, in Korea. Today the challenges continue, and the American soldier continues to do whatever he's called upon to do to see that the challenges are met. Precision, discipline, skill, and teamwork. The soldier needs them all, and these are exemplified by the United States Army Drill Team. In hundreds of performances, both in person and on television, the drill team has appeared before millions of people with its demonstrations of precision marching and handling of arms. They work with regulation army rifles, their bayonets fixed. Thank you. Now the drill team presents four of its members in a demonstration of rifle twirling with bayonets fixed. From the spirit of 76 to the spirit of the 1970s, there stretches an unbroken and unbreakable chain of service and sacrifice. The individual devotion and professional skill of generations of men and women who have worn the uniform of the United States Army. Perhaps the most fitting and lasting tribute to the effectiveness of that devotion and skill is symbolized here in the flags of the 50 states which formed the Union they fought to establish and maintain and defend. Citizen soldiers from states which go through the alphabet from Alabama to Wyoming, together with all Americans, in or out of uniform, are represented here in the parade of flags. Finally, from high in the corners of the vast auditorium, two buglers echo the notes of the lone bugler in the spotlight as he concludes the pageant with the haunting Silver Taps. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Army has brought to you its prelude to Taps.